been neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. The Lord be with you. We come together today, beloved, for the funeral of Joan Mavis Catchpole, a beloved wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, and friend to many. Her earthly labors ended. We pray for her and commend her soul to our loving and faithful God and commit her body to the ground. We pray also for those now in sorrow as we make our last farewells. We can take comfort that death does not unravel the ties of love between family and friends. And even in the midst of sorrow, we look forward in faith to the day of resurrection when all God's children will be reunited in the joy and peace of Christ. And so let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant, John, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through the same, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please would you be seated. As we begin our service, we call to mind the memories of Joan through the words of Mark Verdon. Mark was born on the 3rd of June, 1928, to Doris and Stanley in North London, Cornwall. Patricia was born. Mom and Dad worked very hard, and Dad had three girls at the time. The war came, and both girls were evacuated to the Cotswolds. Mom was very lucky and was taken in by a rich, kind family who were butchers at Great Milton. She'd never eaten so well. At the end of the war, they were so fond of her that they wanted to adopt her. Sadly, Aunt Pat was not so lucky, and at the tender age of only six, she was made to work for her care. She had several placements until, through my aunt and Doris, those came and brought the little girl back to London when the doodle bugs were flying over. Mom stayed on with the butchers. My mom helped look after her younger sister during those difficult times, and Pat has never forgotten. When the war ended, Mum returned home to London. Her father had a good job in the RAF. Mum got a good job working for Lloyd Shipping. It was secret work following the course of ships, and Mum was using the earliest known photocopier. Mum and best friend, Babs Austin, from London, went to Blackpool. They were at the ice rink. My dad, Matthew, leaned over and said, "I'll help you get your skates on." They got on and arranged to meet at the park the next day. They missed each other at that moment, but they did find one another eventually. On their second date, Dad said, "I'm going to marry you." And they indeed got married 2 years later when Mum was 18 and Dad 22. Dad was a dispatch motorbike rider during the war, which suited him. He was so gentle and did not like harm of people. After getting married, they lived in a bedsit and worked in London and saved up for their bungalow in Hornchurch in Essex. They worked and played hard. They loved going dancing, and Mum did evening classes as well. Mum changed jobs, going to work after a time of a break for William Carey for about 4 years. And then I, Margaret, appeared in 1954 in their bungalow. Dad worked in insurance and later became an apprentice radio and television technician. They bought a converted semi-detached house, which had a shop in the front room at Sanders Road in Scotland. Dad sold and rented televisions and repaired and sold other electrical goods. time there was a bus strike. Dad was very entrepreneurial and bought lots of bicycles and kept them in a big shed at the bottom of the garden and did very well for himself. His business was called Good Service Radio. We were there for 7 years, and then my brother David was born in 1957. Russell was born in 1961. So they decided they needed more space and had changed. So eventually, after looking around, they rented a big shop on Strand Parade near Durrington Station in Worthing. Mum worked there part-time between being a mum and a housekeeper upstairs in our flat above the shop. Russell told me recently that people would come in for something like batteries, and they would soon come out with a new radio or even a washing machine when Mum served them. People that love my mum and dad as they provided a good service, Dad mending all the appliances and bringing them back to life. We've all grown up there and had our lives. Mum always had great care for others, helping other mothers with young children, and a real heart for animals, caring for the injured and taking them to vets. Mum and Dad wanted to bungle around the corner in Frobisher Close after Mum's mum died in about 1986. Dad sold the shop in 1989 when he was 65 and worked for another radio shop for a couple of years before retiring properly. Even when he was retired, people would still bring TVs round to the bungalow to be mended. Luckily, they had lots of caravan holidays and foreign ones too. Dad became unwell and sadly died in 2004. Mum trundled on by herself. Her health began to fail as well. Dave worked part-time and went round there 7 times a week. She had a tragic fibrillation in her heart. Eventually this year, she went to hospital 3 times because of her heart condition. The 3rd time, because Worthing needed a bed space for COVID patients, she was sent to East Grinstead with nothing but what she was wearing, and she would never return home. She lost so much weight that I bought her a completely new wardrobe in a tiny size. Went in on the 13th of April and died between dinner and pudding while having a laugh with the carers on the 9th of January this year. So having called to mind those memories of John, let us hear a reading from the Revelation to St. John. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away."
Really gone as long as I believe.
and given us gifts and talents with which to serve you. We thank you for Joan, for the years we shared with her, the good we saw in her, the love we received from her. Now give us the strength and courage to leave her in your care, confident in your promise of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
O Father of all, we pray to you for Joan, for her beloved and dear departed husband Matthew, and all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant them your peace. Let light perpetual shine upon them, and in your loving wisdom and almighty power, work in them the good purpose of your perfect will, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son, Jesus Christ, wept at the grave of his friend Lazarus, look with compassion on those who are now in sorrow and affliction at the death of your servant, John. And especially look on her children, Russell, Margaret and David, her grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and all her family and friends who miss her so dearly. Comfort them with your gracious consolations. Make them know that all things work together for good to them that love you. We grant them evermore sure trust and confidence in your fatherly care, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Your Son, by dying for us, conquered death, and by rising again, restored us to eternal life. May we then go forward eagerly to meet our Redeemer, and after our life on earth, be you united with all our brothers and sisters in that place where every tear is wiped away and all things are made new, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. And now let us pray the words that our Savior Christ himself gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We have prayed for Joan and for ourselves, and now we must commend her body to the safekeeping of our loving God. We will sprinkle Joan's body with holy water, calling for baptism, knowing that in baptism Joan died with Christ. So we have hope and expectation that she will rise with him to eternal and everlasting life. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again. The love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We commend to you, O Lord, the soul of your servant Joan. May she, though dead to this world, find her life forever with you. Of your merciful goodness, forgive her whatever sin she may have committed through human frailty. And in your goodness, grant her everlasting light and peace. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
May the angels, archangels, and all the heavenly hosts, all the saints, come.
come and meet and welcome you. And may your portion this day be in gladness and peace, and your dwelling in paradise. Go forth upon your journey, O Christian soul.
Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal body. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. And when we will see you face to face in your life, we will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. We have entrusted Joan to God, so we now commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus. Died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Dear friends, as we depart from this place, heart, bereft of our beloved Joan, as she was a gift to us in our lives, so let us pray that God will bless us with his blessing that we may carry on in her absence. The peace of God which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you this day and evermore. Amen.
Planets and the stars, leave this lonely world of ours. Escape the sorrow and the pain and fly again. Your endless journey has begun. Take your gentle happiness, far too beautiful for this. Cross over to the other shore. There is peace forevermore. But hold this memory bittersweet until we meet. Fly, fly, do not fear. Don't waste a breath, don't shed a tear. Your heart is pure, your soul is free. Be on your way, don't wait for me. Above the universe you'll climb, on beyond the hands of time. The moon will rise, the sun will set. Life.